If you needed some coins to build that dream team you guys have always wanted, head on over to my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They have the cheapest, the quickest, and the most reliable coins on the market right now. Make sure to use code Poodle for 20% off at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. Today, I'm going to be going over the top most overpowered card you need to power up in this game. Now, this applies for two things, right? It's not just cards you could power up and get them to, like, their top overall before their full card. It's a mix. It's going to be those cards, and it's going to be cards that you just have, if you power them up, their card becomes godly. I'm going to throw them both in. For the most part, it's about the top end part of the cards, but most of these cards also have the ability to be very, very unique and good, even at their lower overall as a top power-up card. I'm going to go over all that in the video, obviously, for you guys. We haven't done this video in maybe a month. Like, we used to do this quite a lot for you guys when the game was first starting out. Power-ups came down a little bit for most people, but I think this is a good time to drop another one of these videos for you guys. Hopefully, it can help you out. If you guys are new to the channel, make sure down below, hit that subscribe button. Boys, we did it. We hit 11K. I'm super hyped, boys. That's crazy. 11,000 subscribers on YouTube, boys. You guys are killing it. This family keeps growing day by day, and it's all thanks to you guys. If you guys want to keep up this level of growth and keep growing our community and within the Madden community, just keep smashing that like button, because this video to 250 likes. Keep commenting down below. Say what's up. And come join the family. Hit that subscribe button. Turn on that noti bell, boys. Thank you so much for all the support. Now let's get into this video. So I was gonna run this through my team for some cards, because some of these cards I have already, so I'll run it through my team a little bit of it. So real quick, you come on down to Aaron Donald. I think this is one of the best cards to power up in this game. Now he's gonna be at the bottom of the list only because his next card is a limited time, so you're really gonna have to get past that barrier, the limited time barrier, as I call it, to get to the next level. But he can get all this way with just a power pass and some training. Look at his stats, right? 75 speed, 83 strength, 75 speed, 83 excel, 89 strength. Pretty solid. 83 tackle, 90 play rec, 89 block shed, 91 power move, 87 finesse move. Now, obviously, this is without chems and everything. If you toss all his chems on and everything, he'll hit all the thresholds. He'll have the power threshold, the finesse move threshold, the play rec threshold, the block shed threshold. Pretty much everything you need from him. And this is without at a 90 overall. It's pretty solid. Now, the next guy. See, this guy's confusing. In my eyes, he's a beast. Other people want to talk crap about him. It's all circumstantial, right? Like, what do you guys think? So, for me personally, this guy right here, Dante Hall, has to be one of the best power-up cards in the game. Now, you guys might be wondering, right, like, his catching stats suck and all. But it's not about what he can do with the catch. First off, if you power him up, it will only cost you like 250K. Powered up, he ends up with like a 90 speed with all that bad catching stats. But that's okay, because what matters to me is this stats on the back of the card. He has 93 agility, right? 93 excel. He's got 85 carrying. That's huge for kick returns and catching, because they fumble a lot. Now wait, it gets better. 94 kick return, 94 elusiveness, 94 ball carry vision, 93 spin move, 94 juke move. Guys, do you realize what this card is? People see this card as a really bad wide receiver, but I do not. And break tackle, 93. I see this card as a way to put a running back at kick return with no penalty. Because, see, like, I could put Saquon Barkley at kick returner, right? But the issue with that would be he'd be really tired when you come to the game. And I feel like when you play people out of position, they don't play nearly as good. But he'd be really tired and he won't play on offense right away. Now, Dante Hall arguably has better ball carry moves than Saquon Barkley, can break tackles just as well, probably a little more shifty, and Dante Hall can get evasive. So imagine a kick returner with evasive that literally doesn't affect your offense at all. I think that's kind of glitchy. And not to mention the fact that you can also use this card as a wide receiver. I wouldn't use him as an outside. I'd use him as a slot. Think about it. You run a drag with him. Drags it open all day. I would only run open routes with him, right? Like those routes that you do, like the one-yard catches and then see if you can do afterwards. Having a wide receiver with evasive would be pretty glitchy too. I don't know if it's just me, guys. I think he's got to be pretty OP in my personal opinion. Now, next on the list is going to be the greatest defensive player of all time in a lot of people's eyes. Now, he isn't all the way down the list yet because he hasn't gotten a new card in quite a while. But he's still up there. It's not Derek Brooks. It is Lawrence Taylor, 91 overall. Look at those stats powered up. And remember, Lawrence Taylor is one of those guys you don't have to power up all the way. If you just power him up to like his 88 or his 89 or whatever, he still is very, very amazing and still very, very useful even at that. He has 85 speed, 88 excel, 86 strength, 86 tackle, 85 play rec, 86 block shed, 90 power move, and 88 finesse move. So he has pass rushing threshold, almost run stuffing thresholds with high speed, with high excel. His next card, guys, I want to let you know, his next card is when he becomes a god. His next card is when his speed's almost at a 90, which is crazy. His tackle's above a 90. His play rec should be about a 90. And these are all with chems, right? He's going to hit everything. Block shed should be a 90. His power is going to be even higher. More ability. That's when this card becomes a god. Now, the next card on this list, guys, honestly, I wanted to at one point have Kevin Mawai on here, but then they dropped this Travis Frederick. Look at this card here, powered up for the 93 overall. Doesn't cost a lot because he's cheap and you can get him for free from your house rules. 90 strength, huge. 95 awareness, huge. 88 pass block, 90 pass block power, 84 pass block finesse. Now, pass block is good, right? Now, for centers, I typically care more about just run blocking, but to have the bonus of the pass block in there too, with one of them being threshold, if you power him up, it gets even higher. Not to mention, his run blocking is 93 run block, 91 run block power, 94 run block finesse. Now, in my lineup with all the chems and everything, his card stats look way better. Just look at that. Look at the stats he has now. And now imagine them all like plus twos. The card's an animal. Truly, truly an animal. And honestly, I wish that... I'm happy I finally made that upgrade. I've been waiting for a new center. Next on the list, we got Torry, Holt, and Jerry Rice, which are not the two guys I want to talk about. That tricked you guys there for a second. It's Randy Moss. Now, Randy Moss... another guy that I use here stock. I use him stock, 90 speed, 91 jumping. That's all that really matters, right? It's that most receivers with above 90 speed do not have good catch in traffic, do not have good catching, don't have good spec catching, don't have good route running. So that's kind of the beauty. Randy Moss gives me a little taste of height, athleticism, and catching. He has really, really good stats. And if you guys do end up taking Randy Moss to your month 10 player, you're going to want him powered up because he's going to get some crazy abilities that you're going to want on him. Now, for me personally, I'm probably going to use my power pass to either get Randy Moss or Deion Sanders. So I'll definitely have one of them at bare minimum. Next on the list, another guy that has been on this list all year, and you guys can hate on it all you want. If I can find a guy to compare him to, there we go, Delanie Walker. It is George Kittle. So now George Kittle was always on this list as an 87, but now... he got his 92 limited card, so he's able to be powered up to a 90 now. So at a 90, look at his stats. Compare him to this 91 Delanie Walker, right? Better speed, same strength, better catching, similar catch in traffic, because it's within threshold, obviously. Way better spec catch, better short route running, better medium route running, almost identical run blocking. So, and he's 6'4". This card's a beast, in my opinion, and he's cheap. He gets the job done, he really does. And not to mention, with Shaker and everything on him, he has like an 84 speed. Well, I have to put him in the lineup to get all the chems and stuff, but you get the point. This card's a beast. An animal, quite honestly, and if I could get that limited time card as a redux for the next series, I can assure you I'll be picking that card up. Next on the list is another guy that... see, these guys are all dual purpose. Like, they can either play as the power-up card, which is Deion Sanders. He's amazing, amazing. Now, guys, one thing I realized about Deion Sanders... I didn't know how important catching was. Like, I used to think catching was just to not drop picks. No. Catching also is for animations. I promise you. Now I know why cornerbacks have such low catching this year, because if they give him above a 70, things get wild. Deion Sanders does certain things that I haven't seen on the other cornerbacks do. Like a contested catch where in this game you know it's going to be a drop, or a contested catch for the receiver. You know your cornerback's not going to make a play. Deion Sanders are like... to give you guys a good example, remember the Super Bowl when they should have ran it with Beast Mode and they passed it to... whoever they passed to, like, Tyler Lockett, or it wasn't Tyler Lockett, wasn't even there, you get the point. Doug Baldwin or whatever, and they passed it to him, and the cornerback, what's his name? Malcolm Butler, like, shouldered him, and he picked it. Deion Sanders gets, like, those animations. Like, he makes some crazy catches where the animation actually goes to him. Like, you know he's going to catch it. It's pretty crazy, guys. 77 catching, he makes some crazy plays, which will probably end up powering him up even more. He has 91 speed, 91 excel, 91 agility, 88 jumping, 88 play rec, 88 man, 83 zone, and 73 press. And that's just as a power-up card. And then if you want to go all the way... he's a monster, and he can play in the kick return game. Next on the list is actually another cornerback that I'm going to toss in here real quick, and that is Denzel Ward. Another guy that powered up, he becomes an animal. Of course, it's not going to work real quick. Why would it? Let's go back in. Denzel Ward, powered up, has a 93 speed. So that's the fastest cornerback in the game without having to spend a million thousand coins, whatever you want to call it, on Deion Sanders. 93 speed, 93 excel, 93 agility. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I compared Denzel Ward to Deion Sanders. Literally, they're the exact same car besides the zone. But then Denzel Ward gets the press, so take that as you will. So, he has 83 agility, 90 jumping, 87 play rec, 83 man, 85 zone, 91 press. With the right chems and the right abilities, he hits every threshold besides the zone, and he'll only miss the zone by like two. So, this card's an animal, guys. You can't go wrong with Denzel Ward. And now, first on the list, the greatest player in the NFL. The greatest guy to ever touch a football, ever. You guys see him last Sunday, you already know. And it ain't Bo Jackson. Saquon Barkley, the greatest running back of all time. Just kidding, don't kill me in the comments. But he's amazing, guys. I promise you. I wish I could show you what this guy looks like. Let me go show you guys from my lineup, actually. Let me show you guys. You guys want to see some real stats? Let me show you the lineup. This Saquon Barkley has unreal stats in with my scheme. I promise you, this card powered up is a monster. I wish he got a few more abilities, like any like power abilities, but he still gets the job done. Look at these stats real quick. 90 speed, 92 excel, 95 agility, 96 carry, 76 catching, 88 elusiveness, 81 trucking, 95 break tackle. This card is a monster, guys. You can't go wrong with the Saquon Barkley card. I highly recommend you power him up. And again, even if a new running back comes out, you always need two running backs. This is your stamina. I'm telling you, they get tired real quick. You can always use a second running back, guys. But that is about it for the video. You guys just saw the GOAT. So the video is done. No one's above him. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you're new to the channel, make sure to come join the family. Hit that sub button. Turn on that noti bell. Let's start going to 12K. That's the next goal, boys. Next goal already starting. We're on the road to 20K. If you haven't already, give this video a big thumbs up, boys. Get the video to 200 likes. All the loyal supporters, all the OGs, make sure you're liking the video every time you come out here and watch them. Best way to show support. And comment down below what you guys think I might have missed in this video. What do you think that, what are your favorite power-up cards? Who do you think needs to be powered up this year? But guys, that's it for the video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm out. See you guys next video. Peace.